Hi, welcome back to Legal Voyage YouTube channel. Today I have brought a video on Latin legal maxims. I hope it is very important for you all to know the proper pronunciation as well as the meaning of some commonly used legal maxims. These legal maxims formulate legal policies which are used by judges and lawyers alike. So as law students even, you will come across a lot of legal maxims in your studies. So it is very important to know their proper meaning and pronunciation. And also remember that most of these maxims have been given statutory authority in recent times because they play a very vital role in deciding cases. So let's start out with few of the very commonly used maxims. Guardian-ad-litem. A guardian-ad-litem is a person specially appointed by court to represent a minor who is made a defendant in an action. So simply, a guardian ad litem is someone appointed by the court to represent a minor in a court action because a minor cannot represent himself. So if a person is involved in a custody dispute, the court will appoint an individual to represent the child in the child's best interest. So what a guardian ad litem has to do is to conduct an independent investigation and make recommendations to the court as to what he feels the best interest of the child is. So that is a guardian ad litem. Alibi. Alibi is a defense where an accused pleads before a court that he was present elsewhere at the time of commission of a crime. So basically, an alibi is a statement made by an accused explaining where he or she was at the time the particular offense was committed. A vinculo matrimonii. This legal maxim comes under the law of divorce or family law. A direct translation of this means from the bonds of marriage. The meaning of this is a divorce that absolutely dissolves the marriage bond and releases the spouses from all matrimonial obligations. So if a person files a divorce action and if he receives a divorce of vinculo matrimonii, this means he has legally dissolved his marriage and he is no longer under any matrimonial obligation. A mensa et thoro. This is another legal maxim that often comes up in the law of divorce. A direct translation of this means from bed and board. A legal separation granted by court where the spouses are not legally obligated to live together but their marriage has not been dissolved. So this means this is a type of divorce where the spouses have been legally separated but their marriage bond remains. They cannot remarry and they will continue to have their matrimonial obligations although they are not bound to live together. Doli incapax, incapable of evil. This means a person is deemed incapable of forming the intent to commit a crime or tort, especially by reason of age. This is also called as the age of penal majority or the age of criminal liability. Most of the countries consider that a child below 7 years or between the ages of 7 to 12 years cannot commit a crime because they cannot make a clear distinction between right and wrong. In Sri Lanka, Section 75 of the Penal Code was amended by the Act No. 10 of 2018, which raised the age of criminal liability from 8 years to 12 years. However, this age of criminal liability varies from country to country. Sub judice, under a judge. This refers to cases under judicial consideration, therefore prohibited from public discussion elsewhere. In many countries, including Sri Lanka, South Africa, Australia, India, etc., it is generally considered inappropriate to comment publicly on cases sub judice. It can be considered as an offense leading to contempt of court proceedings. However, in US and some other countries, there are concerns that restrictions on comments sub judice hinder the rights of free speech. Amicus curiae, friend of the court. This refers to a person who assists a court by offering information or advice regarding a case before it. He is not a person solicited by any of the parties to a case, but he is a person who has an interest in the outcome of the case, therefore offers information that may affect the decision of the case. If allowed by a court, the amicus curiae can file briefs called amicus briefs and argue the case while introducing evidence. Caveat emptor, let the buyer beware. Under this principle, a buyer cannot recover damages from the seller for defects of property that render the property unfit for its ordinary purposes, because the burden is on the buyer to perform due diligence before making a purchase. However, if the seller has actively concealed the latent defects, or if he has materially misrepresented the buyer amounting to fraud, in those circumstances the buyer can recover damages from the seller. Also, the Sales of Goods Act has introduced some express and implied warranties which shift the burden towards the seller to make sure that the goods that he sells are fit for its purpose. Caveat venditor, let the seller beware. In contrast to widely known saying of caveat emptor, caveat venditor cautions the seller that he is responsible for any problem that the buyer might encounter with a service or a product. The seller is made accountable for providing information about the goods to the buyer and to make sure that the goods are fit for its purpose. Currently, this maxim has more prominence than the outdated principle of caveat emptor, and this forces the seller to take responsibility for the products that he sells, and it discourages the seller from selling products of unreasonable quality. Alimony pendente lite, pending litigation. This is the type of alimony that is temporarily provided to the lower earning spouse by the higher earning spouse while the divorce action is pending. De minimis non curat lex. The law does not concern itself with trifles. This is the principle of law that says a court does not concern with insignificant or minor matters. Per incuriam. Per incuriam refers to a judgment of a court which has been decided without reference to an earlier judgment. The significance of a judgment decided per incuriam is that it does not then have to be followed as precedent by a lower court.